you see when the tables turn. You say I love I and I breathe it. So every land of hate will burn. I was there when the ships came and chastised in a Jesus name. One day be crazy, one day be safe. But people are Rome and go up in a flame. I don't know if you walk in a golden star.
What's up, Lemon? Oh, go on. And are you hearing the song okay, Lemon? Is it too loud? I'm gonna play some music, then we get to the reasoning. A lot has happened, and I need to touch on a little point that I realized today. Something that really shook me. So I said, I could go on. I'll go on KNJ. Much love in other place. By the way, Bamba Chalice is available in the link below description. And find the eBay sites for the chalices. So I said, just go and play some music and thing. Get my mind working. We have a lot to talk about. We have a lot to talk about. Mostly about the Libya situation. It's sad that it's not getting the social media coverage that it should.
I'm keeping color.
Africa. Now here comes the season green from England. Now she come with her empty bottle. Now she come to pass the tequila to Papiation. And now I go down to the Elvis and I rip Papiation. I know them up in Kiwi with the taxation. But I beg you please tell me to the mother. And I beg you let me go home. I bring the phone and eat.
Organ Sasqua Station. And it's all good, trust me. We all been working. I've been busy thanks to the services. So yeah. Just a start up the vibe, play some song. If you talk about Wagwan in Libya, and it touched me because I go and draw the race card on this. Seems like no one cares about black people, especially Africa. So I'm going to talk about it. I'll be posting it up on my social media. It's foolishness. It's ends of fuckery. In basicness, in the fuckery. So I just want to talk about it, but music time.
They never told us that black is beautiful. If you are behaving on a one like you never spent 500 years on a farm, the same thing you want to be on a one is another black life you see early on board. You will find out from a girl.
Piccolo, if you make that underground nation, consider me a member of it. I'm tired of this earth right now. I'm tired of the world. I'm tired of the foolishness we have gone, the ends of mistreatment for fellow people, regardless of race. Say that, man. Can't swim, but me learn just to get out of this foolishness. Yes, I live on an island and I can't swim. The irony. Trust me, it's funny, but yeah. I learn how to swim just to make sure I'm gonna leave this foolishness.
Black is beautiful.
It's a Bali. Patience. How many years to make this nation? They said you're willing to move, Sasquatch.
People that's just ignorant.
truth. Be patient. For now, who wrote the Bible? Who wrote the Quran? It wasn't a lightning star that gave birth to the earth and then back the source of all. Who made up words? Who made up numbers? And what kind of spell is mankind under? Everything on the planet we preserve and can it. Microwave it, try it, no matter what, we're surviving. What's human? What's man? What's human? Anything along the land we're consuming. Eating, deleting, growing, trying to get paper. Gotta have land, gotta have acres. So I can sit back like Jack Nicholson, watch niggas play the game like the Lakers. In a world full of 52 fakers, gypsies, seances, listen to prayers. You're superstitious, don't so far with your shoulders, make a wish for the day, cuz. Like somebody got a dollar me, I'm sticking needles in my artery, but I can't feel it. Sometimes like part of me, but I got a real big spirit. A fearless, a fearless. But you try to grab hold of my soul. It's like a military soldier, since 7 years old. I held real dead bodies in my arms, feel the body turn cold, oh. Why we born in the first place, and this is how we gotta go today.
Patience indeed. Next song, Another Day My Molly, it was written. Don't worry, that Jamaican sativa gonna be on its way. I said I found a great link to some lamb's bread, some good strains from down here. Individuals that are preserving the breed. So most definitely, once I got the hookup settled and I set up the seed thing, you guys can get Jamaican seeds, Jamaican sativas, indicas, and hand races. Also, it's Chalice auction. When you make your purchase and you've won the bid, what will happen is basically you'll be getting 10 seeds sent out after the Chalice. So these 10 seeds are random, so you'll be getting fire. And yes, fast move indeed. Can't sit down and wait on nobody. So gotta be moving, gotta be getting that cannabis game thing on point. As I said, gonna be working with individuals throughout the island to see where we can preserve strains, set up decent grow areas, and just make the weed capital of the world, Jamaica, stay the weed capital. Do you remember the idea? I'm just crazy at the things.
Do clock in bed. But now I'm rocking here on a rocking chair. Yeah, the block is here, yeah, the block is here. At the top of stairs, nigga, Rocky's here. Self-centered. Everybody tell me that I'm self-centered. But they ain't got a fucking clue. Another nigga gone is like the 12th sentence. Changes. Shit's much different from the dangers. Shit looks different from the neighbors. Your shit's much different, it was dangerous. That was man's bridge and never strangers. We bought bank seven nigga saviors. I watch man begging nigga save us. And that man's never put in wages. I'm mentally fucked. I'm mentally scarred, I'm meant to be up. I'm meant to be high, I'm meant to be chuffed. From my foot, from my life, I'm mentally stuck. Man, I jump on my chair, you meant shedding buck. They just locked niggas up, they sent for the cuffs. Had to call on my girl and sent for my stuff. Found the day I walked out, it went through my guts. So in charge, everybody's watching niggas, so it starts. Everybody's watching, thinking, oh, it starts. Everybody's showing cards. But that's that. Man's just pussy like a black cat. And man's just looking like a flash chap. D-square jacket and a flash cap. I made for this. I came for that. I paid for this. I changed for this. I never left. I stayed for this. Fucking hell. I do this for my niggas that are stuck in jail. I do this for my niggas that got up and fell. I do this for my brothers, nigga, fuck a cell. Lord, thank you for your blessing, man. Every bloody morning, nigga, gotta get that blessing, fam. Gotta bring that message, fam. Peanut butter sticky, get me out that message, jam. Them Giuseppe shoes, won't delay that special, man. It was them Peckham dudes jumping out like Peckham, man. Old school. Smoking on that method, man.
And no worries. When I get them, now you're going to take care of them people, though. Regarding growing them, if you need any assistance, trust me, you can always hit me up. I got growers here in Jamaica that I'm going to be working with. So we're going to definitely work you out if you have any concerns, if it's looking weird. And yes, the man gigs. As I said, you converted me. Me LMG and best up T man in the place. I said, just a mellow the place, have a steady vibe before getting to some things.
Time's ticking. In the kitchen with Kentucky fried frying chicken. In the fried with the hottest chip, but I ain't kissing. Trying to hide up the pussy bucket, I ain't fishing. When the fries are the bucket, nigga, I ain't dissing. Tell a man to his face, fuck it, I ain't bitching. But fuck it, back to the kitchen, nigga, fine whipping, nigga, whipping, nigga, white shipping. Why listen? Night, make the boy living. Man, I ride with that silly night, why listen? Buck a vibe, why miss it? Yeah, Rico, while mission, yeah, beat toast, why skipping, booty, Debo, fly tipping, yeah.
By the way, guys, share the link to the live, make people know on Instagram. Let's just start a vibe and get everything pumping. Let's start talking something real serious. And it's not going to be just me talking about it. I'm going to raise awareness because, in all honesty, the world needs to know what's going on. Run the road. Stuff this up. Light it up. Ten step ahead of them. Sometimes you have to 10 step ahead of the haters and the hate in this world. Dodge. Dive. Run from bad mind and dirtiness. Sometimes I can't walk away and turn the other cheek. You have to run from negativity. No, make it enter your life no way possible.
Why not let my demon in the city?
And that is correct. 2 pieces, 20 seeds. A much love creepy crawler, we're gonna impress. By the way, a couple of the guys be crushing on your Instagram pics. I was like, yo, big up that Empress, yeah. I was going through the Instagram, I was like, yo. Creepy Empress, Creepy Carla, she's the one that was in the chat. I say, yo, man, no, man, she can't do road at Jamaica. So you got much love and fans and secret admirers down here in Jamaica. So much love, Empress. And well done, everybody. No worries about that. No worries about that, Empress. I said, I have to bless up the beautiful women in this world. And trust me, Jamaican man not afraid to say them things there. Indie on the mix. Wagwan. It'd be nice to have my own radio station, but nope. Well, hope you feel better, Empress, and blessings and healing energy to you. And definitely, when I get my passport and visa sorted out, I'll be making trips in the U.S. Market off as business trips, but gonna definitely be stopping by to see some people. Much love and respect, Midwest Outlaw. And having a great day just here, getting the vibe in. Said, I want to talk to him about something. Hopefully, I appreciate it and look into what I'm saying. It's in bed and counting sheep. And when they wake up in the morning, they be living sweet. Enterprise operation, you're up when need. But to business, everything on beat. No man do more than them share. That is true. Let us all send positive energy to a creepy crawler and make you feel better. Get over the cold. No man go wrong when the big man said. No man no greedy and not good bread. No man no go wrong to buy a lot. All this liar get near bound crash. Now we are getting out the street. Late at night when they must sleep. Now we are getting out the street. Late at night when they must sleep. Now we are getting out the street. Late at night when they must sleep. Now we are getting out the street. Late at night when they must sleep. Yeah, man. The vibes cartel. I'm not gonna see me out, we see the Yo, Isaac, any day you get to sit down with me and get to smoke weed, I tell you this, I'm not like a very social person. I do have that social anxiety thing and shyness about me. But once I am comfortable with you, I'm going to have the best time. We're going to be talking. And once you pick my mind, you'll be surprised what topics you can reason with me. And it's just a good time. I just want to have a positive time when I'm enjoying my medication. And said to me, this is medication where it helps with my anxiety, relaxes my mind, and put things into perspective. That was Miracle by Vibes Cartel. Now that everything seems to be in perspective. Welcome, people. What's up? Much love. How is everyone doing today? Welcome. Best of from Jamaica. So, yeah, one thing I wanted to touch on today. Brush off my lip. Yeah, I said, one thing I want to touch on today. Today, when I woke my grandma, significant other messaged me and was asking, Randy, do you know about the Libya situation? I'm like, no, because generally we're not getting a lot of coverage on that. Don't know why. It's mostly celebrities posting up their responses. And I said, to anyone that is uncomfortable with this topic, do apologize, but this is something that I personally need to talk about. And with that, if you feel offended, if you feel uncomfortable, let me know. But at the end of the day, it's something that is happening in this world. And I will be damned if I go blindly looking at my life and what I want before I look into what's going on around me. Because at the end of the day, I am a member of the human race. I'm a member of the world. I have some form of input in this. So with that, when I looked into it, I'm seeing that immigrants from Libya are being sold off as slaves. Hung up, strung up, beaten. Things that I've read about in high school. The things that I've had to study to pass an exam. The horrors of slavery. 2017, I'm having to relive that because something wrong, something horribly wrong is going on in this world. How can we as a country, as a nation, as a world, as a species, go blindly and pass this over as just another occurrence? No. Even if it's because they're black, I'm black, so it hits home hard. Irregardless of race, creed, denomination, whatever you are, no one should be subjected to any form of dehumanization. You've made an individual with thought, reason, and freedom of will into a thing. That's not right. That's pushing on limits that should not be in the first place. Well, go on, Dougie. Douglas Fairchild. So yeah, looking into this, I have to say, we need to put out awareness that something wrong is happening in Libya. Something wrong is happening in this world. Throughout this year, we've had mass shootings. I don't even know where to start. The Cynthia Brown thing where the young lady was taken as a sex slave, fought, got free, and is now charged for manslaughter. An 8-year-old strung up, hung by a 14-year-old who thought it was a joke. And now Libya. Citizens of the world. They're not just black. They're not just people. They are members of the whole human race. Members of the human race are being subjected to means that should never have occurred in the first place. This to me is an act of cowardice, idiocy, and just disgust. Why are we repeating the mistakes of our ancestors? Why are we following the same path that will only lead in heartache, destruction, and injustice? I did psychology, and one thing for that I'm grateful, I learned the meaning, the true meaning of insanity. This is why I believe in growth. This is why I believe in pursuing one's dreams, no matter what, changing, adapting. Insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, expecting different results. You can call me crazy, you can call me mad, because I'm two shards of a genius, but you can't see through my vision, so you're gonna call me mad. But insane? No, that's me doing something that should not be. No, that's wrong. No shakiness. No shakiness on that. Why are we repeating the mistakes of our ancestors? Why are we running amok to a world that we should have been taken care of ages ago? We have a battle against a plant. Cannabis, marijuana, weed, ganja, the devil's lettuce, whatever you want to call it. As a nation, as a world, we're fighting a plant that has been healing people for decades. And we're not just talking now, we're not just talking the 90s, the 70s. We're talking back into prehistoric days where, wow, they're now figuring out that we have cannabinoid receptors. Wow. That has been there from the get-go. What is wrong with this world? And I said, I will be damned if I stand by and not say anything. My voice will never be silenced. If it's me against the world, I'll fight for those who cannot fight. I'll be the voice for those who cannot speak. Bring awareness, because at the end of the day, this should not be happening. I just wanted to touch on that point where this has to be spoken about. This has to be shut down. We cannot afford to have stuff like this going on. Maybe a rant, maybe touching on topics that people aren't comfortable with. But I'm not comfortable waking up seeing this. I'm not comfortable waking up to a world that is getting darker and darker each day. And as I shine my little light, it's like a freaking lighter. A lighter in a pitch dark midnight scene. I can do so much, but I'll illuminate the way if needs be. So thank you guys for this moment too. Speak about this topic, and we're going to continue. The auction is going on. Thank you guys for the support. We're just going to continue the good vibe. I said, just really needed to speak about that. I don't know how to say how I feel about this situation. And if I'm pulling the race card, I don't know how to feel as a black man seeing injustice amongst my people. But also, I don't know how to feel or say how I feel about the world darkening. People among different races are being persecuted, being killed, being just, I don't know how to say it. So hopefully one day when I wake up, this world can be brighter. If it's gonna take me a lifetime to do so in my own way, that's my own goal. The goal of mankind is to make better this world, correct the mistakes of the past. Each generation is to take up the mantle that has been passed down generation after generation. That is why we are born. We are basically the flame bearers that will be passing down to the next generation love, unity, peace, and the moral values of this world. What are we passing down if this is the situation that we're in? So until my flame goes out, until my last breath, the mantle I carry shall be of love, unity, and peace amongst all. The mantle I carry shall inspire those to do better. The mantle I carry and pass down to my son, my daughter, to those that will come after me, will be to correct the mistakes that I could not, do better, learn from my mistakes, be a better man than me. I don't want anyone to be like me, be better than me in all ways, because I'm just another individual in this thing called life. So thank you. I'm going to strike this up and get into some positive energy right now. That was a lot. That was a lot, people. Weed it up, rep 420. First time seeing you in here. Much love and blessings. Just came off of a very harsh topic. And bless up the loyal. Bless up to everyone. Peace, love, happiness. That is what we're trying to promote. All of that in one, my brother. All of that in one. So cheers. I'm going to go back to some decent music. Some Jamaican music. What do I got? What do I got? And what won't drive me into copyright? Yes, I can play this one. Skanking.
market shoe. Let me Chalice.
Best of from Jamaica. Skanking sweet indeed. Best up to everyone. I'll go on Cushy Buds 420. Isaac, since you said it, just open up your channel right now. I know for definitely I subscribe to you. If not, beat me 2 times. And I did not. Beat me 2 times. My deepest apologies. So Isaac, you are subscribed too. Can definitely check out your vids. If you're on Instagram, hit me up as well. Definitely. And regarding stuff about Libya, it's all over the world. Just type it in. There's even a documentary that's out there right now about what's going on. Videos on YouTube. And it breaks my heart. What's up to everyone in the chat? Your boy Roy Boy, well gone. How much love? Okay, so we're going to talk about the bamboo chalices. Just went over to the eBay and saw the time and everything and saw what's going on. For now, let me turn this down. That's it. For now, we have three beds. We got one on the large, one on the medium, and one on the small. So we still got more options out there. We got four more chalices unbidded for. So let you guys know what you're going to get with this and what this auction is all about. This is a bamboo chalice made 100% out of bamboo, and the bowl is clay, molded and everything. So it's heat resistant because this bakes in a oven just to get ready. So don't worry about blasting this with heat. It can take it. You got your bamboo mouthpiece, your bamboo hoses. Got a lot down there. Bamboo connectors and everything. So what you can do with the bamboo chalice. For me, but I've set it up different where here will be your outlet for your water and where you can pour your water in. But for me, because it's my baby, I don't mind. I pour my water in here. Cool. What I do, I can light it up, hit it like a bong. My lighter is dead right now, so yeah. Hit it like a bong. This is the actual kachi. Clay bowl is called a kachi. Mine broke, but I can get a replacement anytime, but I'm just hitting it because I do like and love my chalice. Wow, I am high. So yeah, so we got the kachi. It's bigger, so it has an additional function as well. Reason why it's shaped like this is basically it acts as a bowl for a bong and a vaporizer. You got these right here, clay mesh, put it right in, fits in nice and snug. Yeah, got different size kachis, bigger ones for the bigger bamboo chalices. So yes, also I'll be coming out with videos soon to show you how to make the organic coal out of the coconut. So you put your coal here and the heat transfers and steams your herb and it vaporizes all naturally for you. So with that said, what else do we got? So awesome. I'm gonna send out three different attachment pieces of bamboo that you can drop a banger of 12 millimeter, 14 millimeter 14 by 14.5 millimeter as well. May do on the 15 and a 18, but that's depending on if I can get the guys to come over and we get that quickly done. I don't know the actual sizes for the bangers because they do vary, so we're going to send it out enough pieces so you can just drop on and fit to your suit. So yes, you're going to get a bamboo chalice, which is a bong, a vaporizer, and with the attachment at that ring, we got the natural here that has been bidded for. We got the, where is it? We got the small, yeah, these are small. Small natural, small painted. The small painted is still available. So you get your hands on this one as well. Really looks nice. Ooh. Nice. So yeah, we got the mediums. Mediums right here. And got the large. The large, we call them the big bumbo. But trust me, take this out to a party and you tell your friends and if you hit it, last man standing really is a steel warrior. Yeah, you get them with bamboo nipples, yes. I know Lemon is going to be saying that, so yeah. Bamboo nipple right here. Let's see, another one with another bamboo nipple. I can hear Lemon typing it in the chat. I'm not looking at the chat, so yeah. Another bamboo nipple. Everything is all natural and stuff. So yeah, with that, you get the bamboo chalice, the kachi, those stuff. You get also 5 bamboo rolling tips, a bamboo ashtray. You're going to get a stuffer with it. You're going to get a set of these stickers right here. Let me fix this properly. Set of these stickers right here. Got a lot. And what else? Yeah, afterwards, for those who have done this auction, a separate surprise or separate treat will be sent out after the chalices to avoid any complications. I want you guys to get a bamboo chalice. So we'll be sending out after the chalice, like 3 days after, 10 Jamaican seeds for each chalice. So if you buy 2, buy 3, you're getting 10, 10, 10. So that's up to you. But yeah, these seeds will be random mixed. It's basically a mixture of seeds that I've been storing up myself. It's a mixture of purple skunk, white ice, pineapple skunk, mango kush. So I don't know what. But it's Jamaican fire and I know you guys gonna love it. So that's the chalice auction. Tell everyone about it. Drop your bids in. Yeah, make it known. Well gone, people. Much love. We got 4 chalices on bid for. Yeah, the little ones are called Little Miss. Zane? Little Miss. So this is the next Little Miss. Little Miss. The mediums are called Easy Skanking. Come on, after your. Take a hit off of the chalice, you're gonna be skanking easy, bouncing with Bob Marley. I said large ones called Big Bumbo. It big no ass. It big. But in honesty, it's solid. And yes, I can hit this, and I did martial arts, so did kickboxing, so yes, my wrist is hard enough to cause some form of damage, and no damage. This has been dried. All of these bamboos have been dried for weeks. I've taken the time out to ensure that everything was done to secure the bamboo structure, and the overall look of it seems to be nice. Yeah, the wood grains stand out with the varnish. Not bad, not bad indeed. So yes, big bamboo. All done. Somewhat proud. So yes, that's the auction. Links are in the description below. Tell everyone about it. Well, share it on social media, share it on Instagram, wherever. We got a day and 12 hours left. So basically Friday at 2 p.m. the auction ends. I got three more big bumbos that I'll be more likely auctioning off on the 420 Resistance live show with the same package as well. You never know, you might get some Tricky B slaps with it as well. Don't talk to Tricky them about that, but we got an additional three. We got a lot to offer here with the bamboo chalices. Much love to everyone for the support. And well going, people. Yours will become a family heirloom. True that. Trust me, I know some people with some chalice will last for years. I remember it's bamboo. I treated it well, so it's gonna age well. And bamboo does last. Bamboo does last. So you have it generation. Grandkids be like, Grandpa, what is that? Well, grandson, it's a Jamaican chalice. This is called Big Bamboo. Or this is called a miss. That is from a Jamaican. Yeah, you know that Randy guy that's there in Jamaica growing weed now. Yeah. When he started out. Want to take a hit? Want to take a draw? Yeah, man. See if you steal. See if you ready to take on the title. Ready to pass down the heirloom to the next generation. That would be awesome. Grandson be like passing out. Yeah, man, chalice is not hot. No shaky warrior. I doubt when I have kids, they'll allow me to do that with their kids. Again, who knows? That would be a nice way of initiation in the family. Penetrating. Meditating. What's up, Isaac? Straight from Jamaica. I'm going to definitely check out your Instagram. Wow, your YouTube channel, Isaac. By the way, guys, I had a Keef capsule. It's like those sugar-coated capsules of some really nice kefir rosin or something, but it is doing wonders. So Bessa from Jamrock has said, auction right now going, got a day and 12 hours on the bamboo chalices. Said, getting a bamboo chalice, which is a bong, a vaporizer, a dab ring with the bamboo attachments. And with that, you're basically going to be blazing naturally. Also, with the bamboo chalices, you're getting 5 bamboo rolling tips. Look at these babies. So 5 bamboo rolling tips. A bamboo ashtray. Different sizes. Some have a more natural look. Some we just make it odd. So it has character to it. What else are we going to send? We're going to be sending out these stickers. You got stickers, a lot of these. Gonna be stenciled out. So you have the option to put it on your chalice if you want, or anything you want to put it on. And what else? Yes. 3 days after, I'll be sending out some Jamaican seeds, mixture of fire seeds, fire strains that I personally love. And for me, this is the start of a project for me. So these first 10 are special. I want to give out as much, make this as a value package. I want years after this, you can look at your chalice and be like, "Whoa, I got this from Randy when he was just starting out," and you're enjoying your chalice. I want you to enjoy whatever you get. For me, as I said, I did customer service. And the reason why I'm doing my business is because after getting to know you guys, after getting to know the community that I will be serving, because once I open a business, I'll be serving a community. So after getting to know you guys, we'll see how value, quality, that's what I'm defending. So you guys are going to get some real quality products here, some good value. And something you can really look back and say, wow, have a story behind it. Handmade bamboo chalice from Jamaica. No worries, Isaac. I said, I just love the appreciation and the positive energy that you guys give me. I'm grateful for the tree that went off. If all gets sold, my bad. Law of attraction, never use if. When all gets sold, when all of the chalices get sold, I'll be even more grateful. But as I said, thank you very much for the support, the love, encouragement, and much more to come. Just relax and just lay my mother, touch soul. Damian Marley, there for you. Erykah Badu featuring Stephen Marley. Okay, Isaac, I'm going to check out. Do you, you grow hydroponically or soil? Go and check it out on your channel. But root rot can really damage your crops. To help. I mean, if I'm growing in soil, I want definitely not water for a couple of days. Let everything dry out and purge the system. So. Nice, Isaac, liking the plants. Running your root rot. If it's not severe, you can just purge it throughout the system. I mean by that, like, just not water for a couple of days, and then, like, for me, I would not water for, like, 2 to 3 days. That the roots regenerate, stretch, dry up, move how they need to move, and then afterwards, you just water with water, no nutrients in it. Straight water for the first day. Then you add nutrients the second day, and then you just watch it and see what happens. Nice. Growing organic, love that, Isaac. I grow no-till, so my nutrients is basically a compost mixture of fruits, vegetables, eggshells, Epsom salt, molasses, fermented plant juices, all of that mixed up together and bubbling for a day, and just sitting down and just brewing. I ensured that when I was getting the soil, worms were present within the soil. And when I was mixing my soil, what I did was basically mixed it with manure, root peelings. I basically built my soil up so the worms could be eating and feeding and populating and dropping castings. And brewing compost tea, shoes. I think I'm going to do a video on that. It's rather easy. It's rather easy. For what I do, I just get a clean bucket, wash it out with some warm water and some bleach, and then drench it with some warm water again. and basically I fill it up and I get like a old shirt. I just get something that I can tie the stuff from my compost bin, like my fruits, my manure, everything that has been mixed up. I put that within the shirt and tie it up like a tea bag, drop it in, let it submerge, sink down to the bottom. And then I just add my fermented plant juices in the proper measurement, add my molasses. I get a ear stone and I drop that in there and I let it just keep bubbling for a while. Do this outside in an open area because it may foam up after a while. Do it for a good, best result if you can do it for a good 24 hours and let it sit for another 2 days and you got some good compost tea. What I've noticed since I've used that method, my buds are sweet. My buds taste like candy. My buds smell like candy. And the trichome production is boosted. I did a test grow. Well, on my Instagram, you can see my plants. I did a test grow. Coffee grounds, yes. Coffee grounds is awesome. Remember, you're adding back to the organic nature of this plant. So what you see in nature, the coffee beans, they will fall near the weed plant and decompose. So your coffee grounds are a good source of nutrients as well. And also, if you're lucky, the plant will absorb that coffee taste. And one day when you walk into your garden, you smell coffee and you're wondering if it's coming from your cup, but you don't have a cup of coffee. And nice, that's the best time. You've been turning it, you've been watering it. For me, what I do to ensure that the microorganisms still live in the compost, I get molasses water. And like every 3 days, just sprinkle molasses water over that. Turn, 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 and the sun purge it with heat to burn all the ammonic acids and anything harmful that the natural stuff break down. Then I bag it up in a shirt and said, make a tea bag, drop it in and brew some good tea. Shh. I'm here jamming out and don't know this song going to get me. Oh, Jesus. Get me kicked off. Like the video might be removed, but hopefully, I could play something else. Yeah, something else. You guys got me in a vibe. I said, thank you guys for the support with the auction. You got 4 available bamboo chalices that have not been bidded on. With them, you get a bamboo chalice, which is a bong, a dab rig, and a vaporizer, 5 rolling pips, stickers, bamboo ashtray, bamboo stuffer, and afterwards you'll be getting some Jamaican seeds. So as long as it don't taste like coffee. I'm not a coffee person nowadays myself, Piccolo. Kind of stray from it these days, kind of doesn't sit well in my system. But yeah, what you want with your compost is for it to break down and extracting it at the right moment. With you breaking it down for a month, and turnips and stuff. You have enough living organisms within that thing that when you try to brew it in a tea or even just mix it in your soil, you have something that the plants will love, organic, and they will take it up. It's an acquired taste, trust me. I can drink coffee bitter, but as I said, if I take one sip of coffee, that is it for me. I will be put down out of commission. Migraine along with bad set of the runs, I should say, the runs. Yeah. Coffee grounds and everything, it may not have the taste of coffee. Just saying, it's just gonna add to the value. And you never know what may be taken up or absorbed from the roots of the plant. So, like I said, it's always nice to do a little organic planting. Some stuff been sitting and it just put a fungi powder in it. Okay, with that, Isaac, I'm gonna send in the chat my email address. Hit me up there. If you have Google Hangouts, we can definitely talk about composting. Go on, Big Ed. And thank you guys for the grow topic. Anything you want to know about composting or just naturally growing? Let's talk about it. For me, I can grow hydro, grow indoors, in soil, but I like the organic growing more. I like taking from nature and putting in what I need to feed my plants. But yeah, give me a hydro setup and I can do road. I can do wonders. It's easier for me because I'm coming from an IT background. So setting up pumps and all of that electronic stuff. By the time I'm done, say what again? I was saying, regarding any other topics about growing organically, you can go ahead and we can talk about it. I enjoy growing organically these days. I can grow hydro. I can grow indoors. I've basically put my hands in a lot of grow techniques regarding cannabis. So that I know how to grow, in a sense, still learning, still have a far way to go. But yeah, doing my thing here in Jamaica. I like doing organic more. Like the no-till farming, I enjoy because, as I said, I like taking from nature and basically using what I have to feed my plants. I want to ensure that I get the cleanest and the best quality. I'm not running down big buds. Trust me, if I can get a small nug that puts me under, I will love that nug. And vape pen sales, well, go on. Cheers. Welcome to the stream. What's going on is a auction for these bamboo chalices and stuff like that. Just addressing some grow stuff. Oh, sorry, we were saying something about the compost. Oh, all going Sparks. Hey, the fun. Oh, go on, brother. And regarding Isaac, just hit me up on my emails. We'll talk about composting since you're really interested. For me, I just really started up compost teas and brewing. I'm at my third batch and the plants love it. And I'm just going to be seeing where best I can apply the best material, when is the best time for it to be added. Yeah, might do composting, organic, Randy Gaston compost tea. Nice. Nice doing unboxing, Mr. Sparks a Lot. For those who don't know Mr. Sparks a Lot, check out his channel. He is the main mod, the brother, the support. This man is many things and more. Best up, Mr. Sparks a Lot, for always supporting the cannabis community, supporting the community overall, and much love to you. So, yeah, those who don't know him, get to know him. Check out his channel. He has amazing videos. He does unboxings. He does live stream. He does train reviews. He's from the Las Vegas area. If he wants me to say that, that's cool. But yeah, great brother to chill with and meet. Get to know him. Okay, so play back your music because I thought I missed something. I can't wait for Carnival. It's gonna be awesome. And that capsule, that weed capsule, is surely hitting home.
Venus bumper in this song.
That bumper is. I got 3 auctioned off already, so it's going well. My baby right here, I got this one auctioned off. I think it was Midwest that went for the natural. I don't know. I'm not looking at the thing now. But someone went and copped on the natural. One of the big babies, the big bombo, has been taken as well, been bidded for. Too real. Give me permission to watch you. And this chalice right here, I got out as well, one of the mediums. So we got four more available. I said we got four available and it's going well. I'm getting the good support. If all gets, no, I said no ifs. When all gets sold off, I'll be just sending them off to the individuals. And yeah, everything are going good. Thanks for stopping by, Sparks. Much love, my brother, for the support. I like the colors on this, the stripe detail. I said each chalice is different, unique, yes, amongst the chalices. This is another medium. That bumper is so real, it's dangerous. I don't know why, but it's looking dangerous. Okay, double stripe. Yeah. Double stripe. Yeah. Where's the next medium? Oh, this is next medium. Yeah, so different designs. Even the large. By the way, Helix did this one. Helix did this one. Him and his free-handedness. So Helix ensure to make you get a spliff. Big bumbo. Another big one. Another big one. Okay, I think that's it. Last big bumbo. I'm gonna lie, y'all chalices look better than mine. Look at her, Buckingham chalice. Still can't kick them people though. Don't worry, they're gonna be here when we're sending them out, so everybody that was a part of it, we're going to send off a little note as well. And Hash Hands Outdoor Organics, nice. I said, share the link, guys. Let them know that it's on the chalice. The chalice sales are on. Take a picture of this Chalice mess right here and post it up on the Insta. Wow. And bless up Sparks. By the way, we're gonna talk about those vape pens. I need to get some accessories as well. I want to start vaping and a lot of stuff. So I don't know prices and stuff. And Sabali to you, my brother. I'll see if I can go enter that giveaway. I don't really do giveaways, like trying to enter them. I'm like, leave luck out of this. I just buy it when I get the time to. I don't like being lucky. Never work out for me. Sabali means patience. Victim of falling down. Victim of falling down. Three chalices out. So we'll be getting that special package. Blessings to those who have been bidding. And no worries, Hashans. I was here to educate, inform, and make everybody know. Because you do the same for me. At times I don't know what's going on in this world and you guys keep me informed and stuff. I'm falling down. Till I fallen down. So we're at that 2 hour mark. So it's been a pleasure being here with you guys. As said, we have the auction for the bamboo chalices still going on, ends Friday. With that, tell everyone, get your hands on the chalices. As said, you're getting a bamboo bong, vaporizer, and dab rig 3-in-1. You're getting bamboo rolling tips. You're getting stickers. You're getting ashtray. And then afterwards, special souvenir seeds from Jamaica will be sent out. So make people understand what's going on here. I'll be back on more likely with Ben later. I'll just be active here. So keep the notifications on. I'm going to be going and ensure that we get these chalices sold out. So bless up from Jamaica to all. And much love. Peace.